Good afternoon, everyone. Today we are going to discuss about computer-aided process planning. So here first we will discuss about the what is process planning. Process planning is the step-by-step instructions, or otherwise it determines the sequence of operations. Definition: a process planning can be defined as an act of preparing processing documentation for the manufacturing of a piece, part, or an assembly. So usually the process planning is used to make the component economically and competitively. Depending upon the production environment, process plan, it can be rough process planning and detailed process planning. In the rough process planning, only it will be going to mention like who has prepared the route sheet, as well as what kind of operation is going to be takes place and what is the cycle time. So those details only it will be takes place in the rough process plan. Comes into the detailed process plan, it's going to discuss with the who has prepared the route sheet, as well as who at what date he has prepared and who has approved the route sheet and what date he has approved. So those details along with that what operations and which workstation the component going to be machining. So those details plus what kind of tool it can be used on cycle time, like all the details it will be placed on the detailed process plan. So usually initially they are going to make the rough process plan and finally they will be get the detailed process plan. Then comes into the computer aided process planning. So process planning usually it will be done manually. Comes into the computer aided process planning, it will be going to be done with the help of the computer. Process planning, it will be interconnects between the design and manufacturing, but computer aided process planning, it will be interconnect between the computer aided design and computer aided manufacturing. There are CAPP, there are two approaches are there. One will be the variant type CAPP, the next one will be the generative type CAPP. This is also called as types of computer aided process planning. First we will going to discuss about the variant type CAPP. So if you want to create the any new process plan for the particular part design, first step going to derive the GT code number for a particular part. Here GT is the group technology. So usually group technology is the going to arrange the similar type of component in the particular place. The next step, search part family file for GT code number. So here it will be going to search the part family file and it retrieves the GT code number. What is part family here? Part family is going to arrange the similar type of components according to the geometrical shape and sizes. Then next step, retrieve the standard process plan. According to the GT code number, it retrieves the standard process plan from the database. In the database, it retrieved and it goes to the next step, edit existing plan. Like we can modify the process plan sheet. So small minor things it can be modified over here. So or otherwise if you want to write a new process plan, you can write it over here and it can be stored over in the standard process plan database. And next step, process plan formatting. So in these steps, according to the proper format, the process plan sheet is going to be taken as a printout. So here other application programs, it will be helps to the machining area as well as cutting speed, like all those details it will be helps to create the process planning. The next step, the process planning sheet has to be created over here, or otherwise we can say it as a route sheet has to be created over in the final step. So in this one, variant type CAPP, it is also called it as retrieval type CAPP. Why? Because of it retrieves the process plan from the databases. So this is also called it as retrieval type computer aided process planning. So in this variant type CAPP, usually the humans has to be go on sit and he is going to create the process planning sheets. This is about variant type CAPP. Next, we are going to discuss about the generative type process planning. So in the generative type process planning, it will be fully automated one. Once if you are going to enter the data, the final process plan sheet, automatically it will be generated over here with the help of this generative type process planning system. This is also called it as expert systems. So in this generative type CAPP, there are three components are there. First one will be the creation of knowledge base. Second one will be the computer compatible part description CAD model. Third one will be the inference engine. First, we'll discuss about the creation of knowledge base. So this is the primary requirement for an expert system to function. In this, the complete technical knowledge of manufacturing and that logic developed by expert human planners is coded and loaded into the computer. This forms the knowledge base for the generative CAPP system. The second component, computer compatible part description and CAD model. Here, CAPP system is to apply the knowledge base to the point for which the route sheet can be developed. It needs a compatible description information of the part. This is generally done by creating CAD model of the part, which is completely describes the part geometry and dimensional and other process details required over here. In addition, a GT code number of the part giving the part features would help the generative CAPP. The next one, next component is the inference engine. The next requirement of the system is to apply the coded knowledge base to the supplied part description CAD model. That means it should solve the process planning problem for the given part and generate the output. This problem solving procedure is termed as inference engine. So in this inference engine only, the route sheet has to be created over here. So usually we can say the inference engine is a output system. It will be going to interconnect between the creation of knowledge base and computer compatible part description CAD model, and it gives the process sheet. This is about the generative type process planning. So generative type process planning is fully automated. Here there is no invention or no intervention of the human beings. This is about the generative type process planning. Next, we are going to see about the benefits of CAPP. Here, process rationalization and standardization, increased productivity of process plan, reduced lead time for process planning, improved legibility, and incorporation of other application programs. So these are all the benefits you can get the CAPP system. Then comes into the advantages of the CAPP. It reduces the demand of the skilled planner, and second one, reduces the process planning time. Third one, reduces both process planning and manufacturing cost. Next advantage, creates the consistent plans and produces accurate plans, and it increases the productivity. Usually with the help of the CAPP, it improves the productivity of the particular industry, as well as it reduces the lead times of the industry. So these are the main advantages you can get with the help of the CAPP systems.